Trading options during earnings season is the dumbest thing you can do. Hands down, the worst decision you can make. In this video, I'm gonna teach you about every single danger of doing so, why it's gonna tank your account, and at the end of the video, I'm gonna teach you the safest, best earning strategies I've found in my last 6 years trading the market. Let's go. So I know you've been trading the market for maybe 1 month, 3 months, and you think this is the cheat code to take your account up 1,000%. I'm gonna show you some live examples, the real truth about earnings right now. Obviously, you see pictures like this and posts like this, people making 100K, six figures, one single trade trading earnings. And this can make you really excited and wanna do it. This guy right here, he put in $228,000 into AMD calls. We all know what happened. That went up huge, rose those calls 100K for this guy, 64K here, 32K right here. It took his 400K account all the way to 670K. While this could happen to you, this is not the norm. And again, you may get lucky in your first couple months or weeks doing this, but in the long run, this is gonna blow up your account. I'm telling you, you gotta trust me, guys. So I'm curious, guys, why haven't you grabbed my free option trading course in the link in the bio? Check this out, 38K to 399K. This wasn't during earnings, but this was consistent growth over time, and then one single trade during earnings season tanks his account 57%. He lost $227,000 in one single trade, one single stock. This guy, Mr. Behiza, he's popularizing earnings option plays on the internet with 500K subscribers. It's breaking my heart. Everyone's telling me, hey, he nailed this one position, Amazon. He picked calls and Amazon went up. This guy, he's a god. We should be praising him. We should be kissing his feet when he walks. He put in $20,000 into Amazon calls and he was right. Amazon popped 3% the next day, but guess what? This guy didn't make any money. That's the problem with earnings. That's what I'm gonna teach you today. Right now, I'm gonna prove it to you. Amazon up 3.46% after earnings, one single day. Check this out, the options, if I scroll on them, the calls are up -2%. How can you be right about the direction, but not make any money whatsoever with the calls? Or the puts, this is gonna scare you. The puts for Amazon, those are down about 65%. So if you pick puts or calls, guess what? You're a loser. You wouldn't have made any money trading earnings with Amazon, even though the stock popped about 200 bucks in one single day. Isn't that mind blowing? And those are just one of the dangers of many of trading options during earnings season. And we're gonna go more in depth on that right now. Let's go. So quick reminder, please subscribe to the channel, like this video. I would greatly appreciate it. I'm here to make you better every single week. I show up, you show up, we get better. If you want to trade with me 7 days for free, click the link below. So just like we told you that heartbreaking story about Beeson, this Amazon call did not make money, although Amazon popped after earnings. Down 2%, even though they were correct about the earnings direction, because it didn't match the implied move. And we're gonna talk about that because that is the one mistake all option traders make. They think they can just buy a call, it goes up a ton, you make money. But every option has an implied move during earnings, and if you don't beat that implied move, you won't make money. So let's talk about how to calculate that with a stock that has earnings coming up next week. This is one of my favorite stocks personally. This is Space Virgin Galactic, and it has earnings on Monday, August 3rd. We can calculate that implied move by adding up the call and the put position. The price of that should give us the possible move expected by Space. So right here, we have 22 fives for the calls. We're gonna click that. It's gonna add the cost to the screen. Then we're gonna go to the puts and click the same strike price. So 22.5, boom. Now we have both of those positions over here. This is called a straddle, which is probably one of the safest earnings plays for certain stocks that move a lot. And if you beat this number down here, if you think you can move that much, then you can start to make money on one position up or down. We'll talk about this strategy later in the video. Again, it's one of the safer strategies I'm gonna talk about. But again, this 3.45 is the expected move of Space. So if we add that to the stock, right now we're trading at about 22.40. So Space is gonna move up or down $3.45, which is about a 10-15% move on earnings. This is going to be a very violent move, and it could make a lot of people a lot of money if they're holding stock, because with options, you have to move more than 15% to make money. Hopefully that makes sense. If this stock ends up not moving 3.54 points up or down, the option trader is gonna lose money, because that's the implied move. If it doesn't move as much as that, they're gonna lose money. If it moves more than that, they're gonna make money. The best thing to do is just trade stock. If you have the money and the capital to do it, this is a 15% move. If you have $10,000, that's a $1,500 paycheck if you guess the direction. Obviously, it's hard to do, but if it's a company you believe in, it could be a good time to pick up that 15% pop. And if you haven't yet, make sure you grab my two books, Bulletproof Recession Proof Setups, link in the bio, only $3. So I'm gonna visually show you this on the chart. So this is space right now. The price of space is around $22.45. So what you can do is plot that move up and down, and that's gonna show you how much it has to move. So right now, space is at 22.5. If it drops $3.50 below, it's gonna hit $19. So that red line is that point where you're gonna make money from this trade. And the green line is the point we're gonna make money from this trade if you hold options during earnings season. So right here, we have that total cost. That's the exact number I use to plot above the strike price and below the strike price. But that number is so important because, again, it's the implied move for earnings. And the best part is, if you don't wanna calculate this, if you have a hard time figuring this out, you can go to this website, which I fully recommend. It's totally free. It tells you the implied move for stocks during earnings. And this could help you understand which ones could move the most, so you can profit from those big moves, maybe stock or options. But again, it's very risky doing this. This is just a good tool to have to know if what you're doing is risky or not. So space, earnings on Monday. If we go down, we're gonna see space is in this one section here. It has an implied move of 21%. So I'm gonna zoom in. As you saw, the last two earnings we had 16% and it moved 14% up. We had 24% and it moved 18% down. So up, down. It's a coin flip at the end of the day. And if we scroll over here, you're gonna see that that implied move is 21.92%, up or down. Who really knows which way it's gonna go? But what I'm noticing here is that option slam has the implied move being higher than what's priced into the option chain currently, meaning there could be some opportunity if option slam is correct and if the option chain is wrong. Again, this move is what is priced in. So if we go 3.45, the percent move exactly is gonna be about 15% priced in. So one of these places is right, one of them is wrong, but there's an opportunity out there. So what I'm gonna do now is give you an in-depth analysis on an actual earnings report, because that's gonna tell you why the stock went up or why the stock went down. If you could read that correctly, you can play the momentum on the very next day. You don't have to worry about holding during earnings season. You can just read the earnings report and play it the next day for the insane volatility that's gonna come about. But I really wanna nail this in your head one more time. And just a reminder, at the end of the video, we're gonna teach you those earnings plays and those earnings strategies I personally use and the safer ones I've developed. But this zone in the middle, the 15% up, 15% down, this blue zone is where you're gonna lose money buying calls in this upper range and buying puts in this lower range. Inside that zone, if you're buying options and holding them during earnings, you're unfortunately not gonna make money. Underneath this red line is where the puts start to make money, and above the green line is where the calls start to make money. So this is visually representing what needs to happen for you to be profitable as an earning option trader. And again, that's like saying unicorns. There's no profitable earning option traders out there. So this is my process to look at the actual earnings reports. Most traders don't even know which website to go to. It's called sec.gov. I have a bookmark to the top. It's the Edgar database right here. Just type in the ticker of the stock you want. Let's check out Amazon. Let's analyze those earnings so I can tell you what to look for. So the 10Qs come out every 6 months. The 8Ks come out every quarter. And we're gonna look at the interactive data on the 10Q, and that's gonna show us the balance sheet, the profit loss statement, all that stuff. And as you can see right here, it's the financial statement section. And you can read this like a pro only if you look at a couple of things. So the first thing is you head to the statement of operations, consolidated statement of operations. This is going to show you the main thing, the top line, the bottom line. There's really only two numbers you need to nail to have a good earnings reaction, a positive earnings reaction, is the top line, bottom line. Top line is just how much money they made in the last 3 months. So they made $88 billion. It's mind-blowing. Last year they made $63 billion, so you just look at that and you say that's a good increase. That's almost 50% year over date, and that is a big pump. So from the top line, they nailed it in my opinion. Their net sales are up huge, and what you can do is compare this to the street. So every year we have the street, which is a bunch of investors, a bunch of hedge funds saying what the number should be. They were expecting it to be $81 billion, which was about a 30% increase. So we have $88 billion. That was an extreme beat by Amazon. So this is a beat in my opinion. I'm pretty excited about it. I would be overly bullish about it, but I still need to dive into it more. So over here's the cost. You still want to analyze the cost, make sure it's not crazy high compared to the past. Total operating cost, about $83 billion. That is some narrow margins. If we scroll down, we have the net income. This is what we call the bottom line, traders. It's the last line of the report, really. And this is the one that we look for to see if they are profitable as a company. So net income is how much they're really bringing in. And this is what we value the company with. So this is $10 per share. So I will use this to calculate the PE ratio. You can use it to calculate the price to sales ratio. But net income from the past is up huge. Just last year, we had $5 net income. We're up 100% from that, meaning the company is 50% cheaper. So this number we use again to calculate the price to earnings. So it's pretty simple. All you have to do is type market cap, and you can find it anywhere on most sites. It's $1.5 trillion. That's a lot of zeros. This is one of my favorite option trading strategies, the backspread with puts or calls. And this is in my option domination course, which comes with 1 month in my trading group. Grab it, link in the bio. So right now I'm gonna teach you how to calculate the price to earnings, because it's gonna tell you how cheap generally the company is. And because this number is higher than last year, we do know the company is valued cheaper unless it popped a lot from last year, which it really did. So Amazon right now is trading at $3,160. And if we divide it by 4 times that earnings per share, we're gonna get about $40 earnings per share for the whole year. This gives us a PE around 80. And this is pretty high for most companies. But again, this is a profitable company that is growing still 30, 50% year over year. So I would think 40, 50 is cheap. 80, 100, a little expensive. Some companies are valued at 3,000, 4,000. Amazon particularly was around 3,000, 4,000 a couple years ago. So this is a more reasonable valuation in my opinion. So just looking at the top and bottom line, I think they completely crushed earnings and crushed their numbers, and I'm pretty excited about this. The other couple things I check are the statements of cash flow. So I just want to see how much cash they have on hand. That means that the money coming into the company is piling up somewhere, or they're using it to invest in other categories. We have the cash on hand being about $27 billion. Last year, looks like it wasn't reported for some reason. Over here, for the 6 months, we have about $36 billion. And for the 6 months, we have $32 billion. So that's about a $4 billion increase on the cash on hand, which is great because they can buy other companies with it. They can invest with it. They can really grow their company faster if they have more cash on hand. And while I'm bullish, this is the very last thing I check, which is next quarter's guidance. Because if guidance is bad and they think the company's gonna start having revenue drops, start gonna have problems from COVID, supply chain, then the stock won't go up as much. Maybe the stock drops. The guidance is the real thing that really creates the confusion with the stock after earnings season, because they can have great numbers. The stock could pop initially, and then the CEO's on the phone saying, hey, we're probably going to shut down the whole company for 2 months, and it's going to reduce revenue tremendously. Boop, and then everyone sells the stock. So what I'm gonna do right now is just search through the 10Q with the Q3. I'm just gonna try to find what I can with it. So right here, we have one sentence talking about Q3. We expect fulfillment, capacity, constraints, effects, changes, blah, 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 blah. increase cost of sales and fulfillment as a percentage of net sales to continue. So basically what I'm seeing is increased cost of supply chain stuff. So costs are going up, net sales, we don't know about that yet. So that's not a good sign. Costs related to COVID are going up apparently. But what we wanna see is the projection, the actual numbers, how much they're expecting to bring in next quarter. So I could not find Q3 guidance on that report. And I just went to Seeking Alpha. You can find it on many websites, but they said Q3 revenue guidance is 87 to 93 billion, which is an increase from this quarter. As you know, they bring in 88 billion. And they're saying this number here is an increase of 24 to 30% year over year. So it looks like each quarter, this company is still growing 30% year over year, which is amazing. This is a growth company. It's still very bullish in my mind. And this estimate right here did beat the street's estimate of 86 billion. So that's, again, super bullish from what I'm seeing, but they're also having a lot of negative impacts from COVID. Jeff Bezos said they spent about 4 billion on costs from COVID last quarter. So unfortunately, this is gonna continue, and this is just something that's gonna negatively affect the company. So I'm still bullish on the stock, and after earnings was released, after the stock popped, I am still bullish. So I think the stock could keep going. But as you know, this whole process of what I did is what investors do, it's what algorithms do. But now let's get into the real reason you're here. Those great earnings trading options that I use, and even the stock ones I use in my accounts. So as we know, space, favorite company, the one strategy I'm using personally is covered calls. And if you use it properly, you should be able to collect income. And if the stock pops, you should make money from that too. So again, like you saw, space, if it moves more than $26, that is where calls will start to make money. But that is where the priced in move is. So me personally, as an options trader, as someone who's a stockholder, what I'm gonna be doing to protect my stock is playing covered calls. So this is the first earnings strategy. And if you own the stock, it's not a bad one to use, because if you are right and the stock pops, you can sell your stock with those covered calls for a premium. Or if you're wrong and the stock drops, you make money on those calls because those calls are gonna expire worthless. This is where we're shorting calls. And this only works if you're holding 100 shares of the stock or more. $100 increments, really. So let's head to the calls. So like I said, $26 is a very important number for traders. So as I scroll up, 26 is right here. Those are trading at 66 bucks. For me personally, I'm holding about 20,000 shares of space. So I can sell about 20 space calls. I can sell 20 space calls during earnings season, and I can make money if it pops, as long as it doesn't pop more than 26. If that happens, I just sell my space position at $26. So here's what happens. I'm having 20 positions. They're trading at about 60. Let's call it $70. So right here, just for me selling 20 space calls and owning 20,000 shares, I can bring in $1,400, because when you short an option, a covered call, you get to bring that in, because every day options lose value. And as long as the option trades below the strike price, which I just showed you is 26, I'm gonna collect that full $1,400 and I get to keep the stock. So if the stock keeps moving for months later, I'll be able to repeat this strategy. But during earnings season, this is a very profitable play because of the movement. You can get so much money just from selling calls and selling puts during earnings season. So right here, 1400 bucks going into my account. If the stock tanks, I make this money. If the stock pops, I make this money. And here's the other thing. Space right now is trading at 22.40. For it to pop to $26, like I said, it has to move 3.5 bucks. But with stock alone, I'm gonna make about $70,000 if space pops during earnings. So if the stock moves to $26, I'm gonna make $70,000 and I can sell my position there. I am totally out of space. And the best thing is, it doesn't stop there. I'm gonna keep the premium from those short calls, which I can add into my profit, which will equal $71,400, which is amazing, traders. So I can make money if the stock pops, and I can make money from exercising my options and selling all of my stock. So that's the one play you can use that's a little bit safer. You gotta own the stock and you gotta be selling calls. It's called covered calls. It's a very safe strategy if you're using stocks you believe in, because those are stocks you don't mind holding, and you can collect passive income by selling those calls higher every single week. And like I said previously, during earnings season, it's the most profitable time to sell these calls. What you can also do, strategy number two, a little bit safer, is if you like the stock, you don't mind owning it, you can sell cash secured puts. So now let's switch to puts. In this scenario, let's say space drops to 19 bucks, which would be a great place to own it. So I could be selling puts right here for 28 bucks per option, and I could sell, let's say, 10 of them. So if I sold 10 of them at about $30 per option, I could collect $300 during earnings if space does not close below 19. So $19. Why did I choose 19? Why did I choose 26? Well, it's this implied move. The implied move is 19 to 26, about 15% up or down. If I'm putting my options around that area, there's a very small chance it's gonna get there, meaning I'm probably gonna collect this income because I'm shorting the options and because the implied move is not going past that point. So 19 bucks, and the downside that it goes to 18 or 15, what I have to do is collect the premium, 300 bucks in my profit, wah wah. But what I also have to do is buy the stock. So I have to buy 10 times 100. So 10 times 100 is gonna be 1,000 times about 19, which is gonna be $19,000 of space stock. Again, we bought the stock at 19, now we can own it forever. But in the meantime, I can collect passive income while space is trading sideways and while it's staying above 19. So if you're feeling bullish or bearish, you can do one of the other options, selling calls or selling puts. These two strategies are probably one of the safer ones because you can profit from the time decay the very next day, the IV drop. So this is my third strategy. It's not my favorite. It's a little bit more risky and the chance of you making money is a little bit smaller. The other two strategies are more passive income because we know options decay. We're just playing with that decay during the best decay season, earnings season. But this strategy involves buying options. So buying options always requires risk. So here we'd be buying, like we said before, the 22 fives. And this would be, as we see up here on Robinhood, a straddle. So straddles are where we're just hoping for a big move. It just has to pass the threshold of 345, which we marked on the screen as $26 and $19. So for us to make money on this, we need to go above those levels. Once that happens, we're all gravy, we're making money. But just like you saw with Beazin, that guy had Amazon calls. He didn't make money after earnings because the implied move was bigger than the actual move. So as long as the implied move is smaller than the actual move, you will make money with straddles. And if you're picking things with very small implied moves and you're getting those big moves, that's gold in my opinion. Again, you can head to optionslam.com. It's one of my favorite websites to see the implied moves. You just go to the earnings calendar right here and you scroll down, you're gonna see all the percent moves here. Obviously anything around 21%, 15%, you much would rather be selling positions, selling options. Anything below 5%, that might be something you can play, because if you get a move to 10, 15%, now the price and move was much smaller than the actual move. That's where you can make money. So I'll just scroll down and we'll just find some good ones. Like right here, we have a 7% mover. What I'm looking for particularly is like 5. So 6% here, let's go to that stock, that's Race. Can we move 6%? And what would tell me if it can move 6% is if the stock is pent up enough. If the pattern tells me it's a breakout pattern, if it's consolidating, if it's not really trending, then I don't think we can move large amounts. So again, when we have trending moves, breakout patterns, that's where we can see this small implied move having a real big actual move, and that's where we can start making money. So that is my three earnings plays that are safer and are gonna help you not blow up your accounts. Earnings season is here and it's a time where stocks move 10 to 20% in one single day. Most traders will lose so much money with the wrong trading strategies. So as someone who runs a professional options trading group, I'm going to teach you the three best option earnings trading strategies. Stay tuned.